So many people seem to think that I'm an AI avatar. Today, we're going to learn how you can make your very own ultra-realistic AI avatar video, and it only takes a few minutes. Let's check out what this even looks like.
Hello, cookie lovers. We have some exciting news to share. The Kevin Cookie Company is expanding to 100 new locations around the world. That means you can enjoy our delicious cookies in more places than ever before.
That is so impressive, and it gets even better. You can take an existing video of yourself, just talking, and then you can translate that into a different language, and it keeps the lips in sync with all of the speech. Here's an example of me speaking in Hindi, and keep a close eye on those lips.
Hi, sabhi. Kevin yahan. Aaj hum Wondershare ke PDF elements ko dekhenge, jo antim PDF sampadan app hai. Thus,
all I can say is that is some AI magic right there. I partnered with Wondershare Verbal to show you how you can do this step by step right now. Best of all, you can try this out entirely for free. All right, let's check this out. To start making AI avatar videos, head to the following website. You can click on the link down below in the description or on the card in the top right-hand corner. With a free account, you can generate up to 2 minutes of AI avatar video, which is a good amount to test it out. But if you need more than that, there are also some premium or paid plans that you can upgrade to. And it looks like if you do that right now, you get 15% off. Right down below, you can install the app directly on your Windows PC, or you could also use it online. And in this video, I'll be using a combination of both, and I'll start with a desktop app. When you finish installing the app, you'll land in an interface that looks like this. And right up at the top, we have a very prominent button to create video. And this will allow us to create a blank new video with an avatar. And in a moment, we'll do this. But first, let's look at some of the other things that you could do here. Down below, we have a few other modes, and in a moment, we'll come back to see what some of those do. Down at the very bottom here, I can see all the different avatars that are available to me. And you have all different types of ethnicities, different genders, different ages, so you have lots of different options to choose from. Right up here, you could also look at various collections to filter down the different avatars. For example, here we have some different fixed backgrounds. There, you'll notice the background behind the avatar. You could also look at gender. Here we have some female avatars, we have male. You also have different categories like marketing, news, or even education. So lots of different options to look through. You could even search through all the different available avatars. So you could spend a bit of time to find the avatar that will perfectly convey your message. Over on the left-hand side, let's click into video template. Here, you'll notice some of the same exact AI avatars, but now they're in a complete scene. So you'll have the background, you have some overlaying text. Just like we saw on the previous screen here too, you could also look through different collections to filter down the videos. Here you could also search and you could look at specific aspect ratios. So are you making a YouTube video or maybe you want to make an Instagram reel or TikTok video? You have that option. Now, I just want to create a blank new avatar video. So on the left-hand side, I'll click back into home and then I'll click on create video. This opens up a prompt where I can select my video aspect ratio. Again, I have those two different options, a horizontal video or here I have a vertical video option. I want to make a YouTube video to announce all of our new cookie locations for the Kevin Cookie Company. I'll select landscape and then click on create video. This now drops me into the editing canvas. And right here, I can see that it's already selected a default avatar. Now, first things first, I want to rename this project so I could find my way back in the future in case I need to make any tweaks to it or if I want to continue working on it. In the top left-hand corner, it's currently called Untitled Draft, and that's not really that helpful. So let's click to rename, and I'm going to call this Opening Cookie Stores. That'll make it really clear what this is about. Right here in the center, I see this avatar and she looks very nice, but I had a different avatar in mind. To select a different avatar, right up above, we have this avatar icon. Now click on this, and this again opens up that entire collection of all these different avatars. Just like we saw on the home screen, I also have all these different categories to find the exact avatar that would best convey my message. Now, I previously looked through here and there's an avatar that I think would work really well, and her name is Lena. I'll click on that, and here it shows me all of the different Lena options. Here I have Lena in a sports outfit, I guess a cute outfit. Here's a fashion outfit, and also customer service. This is for a cookie company and I want it to be somewhat approachable, and I think this fashion one will look kind of fun. I think that looks nice. Over on the left-hand side, I can see a large preview. Now, I think this looks good, so in the bottom right-hand corner, I'll click on OK. And look at that! We now have our new spokesperson for the Kevin Cookie Company. Welcome on board, Lena. With Lena on this slide here, I could reposition her, so I could choose where I want to place her. I could also resize her, so maybe we make Lena, let's make her a little bit bigger, right there. I could also rotate her if she's feeling a little loopy today, but I just want her to be straight up and down. With Lena selected, over on the right-hand side, I also have additional controls. I could choose the style. I could go with a circular view, or here, we could go back to the full body view. I could also set the location, also the layer, and this is interesting if you start bringing in backgrounds or other graphics. And then I have a few additional edit controls down below. But I'm satisfied with Lena in this scene, so I'll stick with her as is. Next, I want to set the background. Right up above, I'll click on the background icon. And over here, just like we saw with the avatars, I have many different options, and I also have all sorts of different collections that I could look through to find a background that works well for this video. I don't know about these for a cookie company, but I think I have a really good one in mind. Right up in the top right-hand corner, I can also upload my own images. And when I click on this, here I have a background of my studio that I present in. I'll select this one. And here I could crop the background, but I'll stick with this scene and then click on upload. And look at that, that now inserts my studio in back of Lena. And right now she looks a little bit small given the size of the background. So let me increase her size and place her right down here. Look at that! I now have an AI avatar that can present in my studio. That looks pretty good so far. Just like with the avatar, when I select an object on the canvas, I get additional controls over on the right-hand side. Right now I have the background selected, and here I could crop the background, I could remove different items from the background, over here you could even add background music or subtitles. So many different options when you select an object. Right up on top, we also have a few additional buttons. Over here, I could click on text, and I can add text to overlay on top of the scene. And here too, many different options. I could also click into stickers, and here we have many different options of stickers that you can include in your scene. Now, of course, you may not find exactly what you're looking for, or maybe you have your very own assets that you would like to include in the scene. Over on the right-hand side, you can click on this icon, and you can upload assets from your computer. You can upload an image file or a video file, and then you can bring that in directly into your scene alongside your avatar. Now that I have the scene all set up, I need to tell her what I want her to say. Down below, I have two different options. I can enter in a text script. And with this, I can type in text, and then she'll say all the text that I enter in here. I can also use what's called an audio script. Here, I could upload audio, I could also extract audio from an existing file, or I could also record the audio directly in this app. And then her lips will match that audio. Now, unfortunately for me, I don't think my voice will work all that well for Lena. It's just a little bit too deep. So I think a text script is probably the better option. With a text script, you have a few different items down below that can help you pull it together. Here, I can use AI to help me write this script. Here, I can take an existing script and then I can optimize it. Maybe I want to shorten it. Maybe I want to make it a little bit happier. I have those different options here. Back here, I can also take existing text and then I can translate it into a different language. And then I can have the avatar speak it in that language. I just want some basic English text, so I don't have a need for this right now, but it's good to know that it's here. I'll close out of this and let me enter in just some basic text that I want Lena to go through. Over on the right, I can define the target language. I'll click on this, and here I see a number of different options, and there are all sorts of different supported languages. Now, I want Lena to speak in English, so I'll click on this dropdown and choose English. And over here for the gender, let's choose female. And here I see all these different options. I could click on the play icon to listen to what that voice sounds like.
Wondershare Verbo. Easy to use.
Okay, so maybe let's go through here and let's see. Ooh, here's English classy explanation. Let me listen to that.
Wondershare Verbo. Easy to use, no need to shoot.
Ooh, I think that really fits well with Lena. I'm gonna go with that one. And right here, I'll select this voice and then click on OK. Down at the very bottom, I can now play the script to hear what it sounds like with this voice that I selected. Let's have a quick listen.
Hello, cookie lovers. We have some exciting news to share. The Kevin Cookie Company is expanding to one...
I think that voice works well. I'm going to go with it. Over on the left-hand side, I could add additional scenes if I would like, but for now, I'm happy with just this simple scene. I think this is really good for the announcement that we're expanding the Kevin Cookie Company. I'm so excited about that. Once you're done configuring your video, in the top right-hand corner, click on the export button. And just like that, it's all finished rendering the video. Over here, I could play the video or I could download it directly to my computer. And this is the exact same video that we saw in the intro. Let's now click back into Home to see what else we can do within Verbo. Back here on the home screen, we have a few additional tools. Here we have the AI Script Assistant, and this is what we saw previously when we pulled together our scene. I'll close out of this. Over here, you could also pull together what's called a talking photo. And here you can upload a photo or you could select from one of these pre-existing photos. You can then type in text, and here the photo will transform into a talking avatar. So pretty cool thing to check out. And I'll close out of this. Here we also have a video translator, and in a moment we'll take a look at this. Over on the right-hand side, you also have something called a transparent background video. This is pretty much identical to the scene that we pulled together, but instead of having a background, the video background will be transparent. That way, you can pull one of these avatars into your own video editing software, and then you could work with it there. So just another option. For now, we're going to shift gears, and for the video translator, I'm going to do this on the web. Here I am now in the web app, and you'll notice that it has very similar functionality to what we saw in the desktop app. In the top left-hand corner of all the different avatars, you'll get a sneak peek of some new and upcoming functionality. Soon, you'll be able to create what's called an instant avatar. This means that you'll be able to create an avatar of yourself. You could then type in text, and your clone, or you, will then speak that text. That's going to be very epic. Up on top, let's click on Video Translator.
On this screen, I can now select a video that I would like to translate into a different language. I'll click here. And right here, I'll select this video and then click on Open. Now that it's finished uploading my video, over here I can choose the original video language. And the video was in English, I'll select that. And then I can choose the target language or the language that I would like the video to be in. And here I have many different options. I think it'd be fun to hear myself in Hindi. I'll select this. Down below, I also have some advanced settings. For example, I could have it be in sync with my lips. That sounds really cool, so I'll make sure to toggle that on. I could also turn on subtitles, and I even have the opportunity to proofread the video script first if I want to make any tweaks. But let's just test it out as is. Down below, I'll click on Translate This Video. And it looks like it's now all done. Let's preview how this turned out.
Hi, sabhi. Kevin yahan. आज हम Wondershare के PDF elements को देखेंगे, जो अंतिम PDF संपादन app है. Thus.
All right. Well, let me know what you think of the tech down below in the comments. Do you see yourself using this in your different workflows? And also, I'd be really curious to hear, do you want to see additional hosts show up on this channel? I've got lots of different options to choose from. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I hope to see you in the next video.